Alright, we are online. Yes, I did the disclaimer. It's a just-in-time talk, also a 40-minute talk squeezed into 20 minutes. That's why I cut almost the theory and will just mold your brains that you will be able to write per six regular regexes. Because the thing is, of course, we know Rakuto and company are slow, but still already useful for certain things, especially when it comes to parsing. Because dropping out some big ugly regex can sometimes be much less effective than have a nice POSIX grammar. And if you have some script which doesn't have to run too fast, that is one of the most purposes I think. To use POSIX today, and you can give these guys nice feedback. Of course, if you start to use POSIX regexes, you will notice some changes. And you, before you scratch your head till you're bleeding, I think I talk some about the major changes. So you'll be after this talk be able to write POSIX regexes without big surprises. That's all right. Yes. Yes. Search for perfection. That's POSIX. Yeah. Now that's my usual pre-talk. We cut that. Now that is depend. If you don't understand POSIX, it looks like that. If you understand POSIX, it's a little bit more like that. No. A fractal is a good method because all the same things are reused over and over again. It's not so much to do. We already showed that. Okay. No. That's just a joke. If you use that, it's all like MEMA. We come to that. Of course, there are of course some things which keep the same, but there are not too many. There is some rules. Yeah. But a lot of has changed. Yeah, of course, the first things, regex, we no longer use the QR because it's an own language, and it that's why it deserves an own operator, because it does something totally different. Yeah, if you want to just put in your code a regex, put rx and slashes into it. And of course, the usual stuff that you not have to use slashes, but you know that already. And you use a smart match to apply, but if you're using a sufficiently modern Perl, you already knew that, yeah? There's no more such. Then we have, I don't have to speak about that, they are still there. But they have also methods which can be called instead of, yeah? For M we have match, for S we have subst, and we have a new nice thing called comp, which just matches your string against the regexes and gives you all the return values which have matched, which is in most cases what you want. Yeah, and if you like more the Java-ish guy and like to program more object-oriented, that's the way to go for you. And then we have this new thing that are the little sisters of M and S. They are the MS and the SS. And there are nothing like shortcuts for that. And now you know nothing more. But we are already reached the modifiers. There's of course no X modifier because it's now standard. There is also no M, no S modifier. They are gone. There is always the same mode. Yeah, and like you say, there is no Xmas. Yeah, they promise you against, but it isn't. All right. There's also no E modifier. and no matter how you spell it, it isn't. Don't try it. Yeah? All right. That's one of the nice things about the regexes in Perl 6. They're regularized a lot. The rules become lesser, and it's also synchronized with the rest of the language. If you wanna use the E, just use curly brackets, which do a block, and it's evaluation like everywhere else. And if you wanna eval the second time, then just use eval. all right. And if you already say, oh crap, I will never understand this, there are these modifiers and you are safe. And of course, that's not the exact syntax, but that is the exact syntax to write the modifiers. There's in every modifier, there is a short version and a long version. Yeah, you will see then they are synonymous. Yeah, and that's the way you will apply them. Yeah, you put them just after the operator. Oh. There are always ways to sneak around rules. All right, I don't will talk about that, or you're in the wrong room. The global, of course, matches as long as it finds something. This says you how many times it will search. Did it just takes so-and-so time? And there are a lot of aliases. We have not a time to go through all of them. Then we can go on from a certain position we search, or just at a certain position. And now we can lift the big secret about the MS and the SS, because that's the modifiers. It's actually not that hard, because you use it all the time. It's called QW. If you type QW, then have the spaces meanings, because they separate the words. And something in that area, which is very, very smart and much too smart to explain it here in short time, also happens with that, which means you can group your things with space, and these spaces have actually a real meaning of space. So everything which is separated by space is also in that what you match has to be separated by space. Yeah, no matter how many space, that's not the important part. And of course, if we are once in this logic, this is of course, if you want to match, and that's this alias, if we the substitution, yeah, if you care about the spaces, it's in the lower row. That's the same with casing. Of course, you know the E modifier, but if you want to do this for regex substitutions, so that the substituted has the same casing like. What you search, then you take the EE, same with markings. And of course, if you're in Unicode, we use that one. Yeah, there it's a meta character. Of course, that's the most important meta character, much overused in UbiScript. But, yeah, of course, did we have time for the nice? Oh. Yeah, yes. No, that was forget almost what you know, and that's all the rest parts. And yeah, that was the real talk. No, and there was the any. That's supposed to be funny. All right, back. Any char. Yes, not like in Perl 5, like you see, that doesn't print you the one, but. It's really any character, yeah? Now the new line is spelled that way, and we have it already in Perl 5.12, backported from the future. Then we have these, no comments, you know all that. And if you took it twice, it's the same just line-wise. That's the beginning of a line, and that's the end of a line, and we don't need multi-line or single-line mode. Question? You looked so unhappy. What, please? Yeah. And then, okay, all right. Oh, I deleted a slide here. No, then is this one, that's already the joke told. If you do that in Perl 5, of course, A wins, yeah? Not so in Perl 6, because here begins, wins the longest, it's the famous longest token matching, because the one singular or is like if you would do it in parallel. Of course, the CPU can only process one at a time, but logically, it's like you would do it in parallel. It's also like you all in the rest of the language. If we do junctions also, if we have one vertical bar, it's always like doing it in parallel. And then we have a rule which wins. Here it's the longest win because we like longest token matching. And if you want to really like the old style, you have to use this. Yeah? That are the capturing groups, like you know it. Non-capturing groups are now spelled that way. And if you say, oh no, where are now the rectangular brackets? They are spelled now so, because you will need them much less now. Because one of some, it doesn't really fit, but it's one of the most important things, the space, of course. You need it all the time, because for digit/digit and slash word, that doesn't have changed much, but backslash space also works like we had it, but just for information, it's now vertical and horizontal space. We distinguish now, and we can use it also one of the other separately. Yeah, vertical space is like things like so new line and such things and. Yeah, and the horizontal of scale tabs and spaces and what you have. Of course, Unicode knows more. Yeah, thank you. No, I read it, but it's all right. The quantifiers have not changed that much, so I don't have to talk down. Here we go just in the goodies. How do we do in the time? 5 minutes, yeah? Is no one has the papers? Okay, so I have to check it for myself. That's terrific. So you have all water. Good. Of course, because the curly braces now are the blocks, we have to do something different. This is a digit exactly 5 times, yeah? Because it's when we do math, out of rack access, this is also 5 times, also hoch 5, yeah? Also inside of the rack access. Even if they are differently languages, they are nicely synchronized, like I said. Yeah? That's why the fractal. That will exactly match, for instance, this nice string. So if you want to have between 2 and 5 times, use this, because this gives you, of course, a range object. No? It's the range between 2 or 5, which is expanded in the array context, of course, to a list. But here it is produced just the range, and it will check if we have so much digits. And this is really nice thing. In the normal Perl, it's of course, I think, the remainder, which, what? There needs to be a quantifier on the plus side. So it would be backslash b plus. So, I'm not. Yes, that is just a single digit. Yes, you mean if you want to search for digits, of course you have to take a plus behind the digit. But you have to have a. All right, I didn't knew that. Thank you. All right. I will change that in the tablet. Thank you. Yes, I didn't. That is for the nice cases where you have when you were before and had things like that, and you really had to jump through hoops to slurp up these numbers. Now you can it easily because you now say these are separated with this sign. Regex, do the job. I'm too lazy. Yeah, and if you know there might be some trailing, just use that version and it still does the job. And of course, you can stack up the modifiers because the crazy in POSIX has no limits. you can do it so, which is a digit. So, of course, the plus is missing, or the all right, yeah, okay, thanks. Two or more times separated by the comma. Perfect. Something to mock? Oh, really? I know. I'm shameless. So now it's right. Thank you. What? And okay, last round, special variables. Oh, I deleted a slide here too. Wow. That don't survive. Okay. Of course, you know the first guy. That's one of the few special variables which survived in PER6, because most others are gone, which is mostly a good thing. And you know, and this is a so-called match object, and you can ask it whatever. You can ask it what was before the match, after the match, how many. It has many methods, but what just will I talk about now is if you use it with these angle brackets, then you can ask about the name captures. And that is a very nice thing in many ways, because on the one hand, for instance, if you do hash subscript, of course we have the curly braces, but inside the curly braces we have also do Anführungsstrichen, the quote signs, thank you. And the angle brackets actually do the same as the curly braces and the quote. So can so you can spare that, and it's actually the same syntax as if you when you ask for the name. So it's very consistent, and you even can leave that one out. And or is it still valid? The syntax. Yeah, and that will give you a name capture of the last regex. Of course, if you do many regex, have to store the object, because it always refers to the last. So far clear? You got, you know what it is, name captures. No, no. If you have to, inside the regex, you have to you can do it with rules or with other names. Give names to sub regexes that match, and then you get under the name. You can ask what this sub regex matched. It's not positional; it's named.
The question was whether a regex needs to match so that it gets overwritten, or if it's not a tried regex.
Yes, I suppose so, but I was not sure. And you're almost done. And of course, we have still, and this is a new one, I think, that wasn't there before, the special variable. This gives you, of course, all the positional. And with the positionals, these are now much saner ordered. Because, you know, if you have some hierarchies, and you have inside some round braces, some another round braces, and now all the order is totally mixed up. Now, there's that is one last thing I didn't come to just 5 minutes before to give on slide, but now it is now you have really arrays of arrays. So the order is doesn't mixed up all the time. Sorry, that's the last thing I couldn't do on slide. This is normally the same as all the positionals. We are starting now with $0. The old $0 is now executable name, which is a much better name. So you can ask, and it doesn't end at $9. It goes $12 and so forth. So you can ask $5 or $6, or you can just, this is like an array. No, this is like an array, yeah, or a head.
Yes,
okay, that's another typo, yeah. Thank you. That's what I meant. Like I said, I just typed it together. Yeah, that's what I meant. In that array, there are all the positional lined up. And of course, if you have inside round braces, other round braces, so would be the first, like be the element of the element. So you have to square bracket zero, square bracket zero. Yeah, so the matches are now nested, which. Deletes much little bit of craziness. All right, and we're done. Thank you for your attention.